morning children. Let us continue with the explanation of electrochemical cell. Yesterday we have studied about the parts and working of electrochemical cell. Here children, we have seen that yesterday zinc loses electrons and gets converted to zinc ions. At the same time, copper ions gains electrons and gets converted to copper. Or zinc acts as anode and copper acts as cathode. The flow of electrons is from anode to cathode, which can be represented with the help of this deflection in galvanometer, and the convection flow of current is from cathode to anode. This is what we have studied yesterday. Today, let us first discuss about the functions of salt bridge. Okay, functions of salt bridge. Children, salt bridge normally perform two functions. First one, you can see that it connects both the beakers, that is both the half cells, that means it completes the circuit in the okay. Now second one, we can say that salt bridge maintains electrical neutrality. It maintains electrical neutrality. Is that term clear? What is this electrical neutrality? Let me explain that. You know that as time passes, zinc rod will be losing electrons and gets converted to zinc ions. That means after some time, this anode will be accumulated by the zinc ions, then the flow of electrons becomes difficult. At the same time, the cathode, you can see the deposition of sulfate radical, since CuSO4 decomposes, so that sulfate and not cathode. Avoid this accumulation, what happened? For example, just consider that this contains potassium chloride. This undergoes and reduces Cl minus. Completes the circuit as well as it makes electric neutrality. Now let us see how to represent an electrochemical cell. In order to represent any electrochemical cell, it is not only this galvanic cell, we can represent any electrochemical cell by applying this particular relation. In this case, first you can then salt be represented by
can
lose electrons or it can gain electron. That means the metal can undergo oxidation or reduction process. Is it clear? So here we can say that whatever be the different electrical potential set up between the electrode and the solution is termed as electrode potential. Is it clear? Whatever be the electrical potential set between the metal and the solution, metal and the solution is termed as electrode potential. Okay, the electrical potential, that is the difference in strength between setup between the electrode and the solution, is termed as electrode potential. It is applicable for the oxidation, it is termed as oxidation potential, and in case of reduction, we can call it as reduction potential. Is it clear, children? Oxidation means the tendency to lose electrons, and reduction means the tendency to gain electrons. So the electrical potential which is set up between the metal and the solution is termed as electrode potential. And this difference in electrode potential between the cathode and the anode is termed as EMF. Or EMF is equal to E cathode minus E anode. Is it clear? Is it clear what is electrode potential? That is when you just put a metal strip in a solution, so either the metal will be showing a tendency to lose electrons or it shows a tendency to gain electrons. Whatever be the case, the electrical potential which is set up between the metal and the solution is termed as electrode potential. Is it clear? Now we are going to study about the last topic in this chapter, that is electrochemical series. Children, in 10th class you have studied about metal activity series. That means in that case we represent only the metals. But here we are going to arrange all the elements. Electrochemical series means it is a series in which the elements are arranged in the increasing values of the reduction potential. Is it clear? It is a series in which elements are arranged in the increasing values of reduction potential. This is what is termed as electrochemical series. Is it clear? The series in which elements are arranged in the increasing values of the reduction potential is termed as electrochemical series. One of the application of electrochemical series is that it helps us to calculate EMF of the cell. You know that it is E cathode minus E anode. The rest, this chapter, that means in detail, we have to study in 12th class. Is it clear, children? Exercise of NCERT, and if there is any doubt, please ask me. Thank you.